almost no one coming from the Dominican Republic to the United States is coming here because they have a provable skill, and that would indicate their likely success in our society.
Mi hija estudia porque yo no quiero que tú trabajes lo que yo estoy haciendo. El que no estudia se queda abajo, siempre está ahí abajo.
This is the first donor who came in here 1960 after Trujillo.
Dominican immigrants started coming to the United States in massive waves in the late 1960s due to the economic and political instability that came after the 31-year dictatorship led by Rafael Leonidas Trujillo. Many intellectuals and working-class people arrived and settled mostly in Washington Heights, New York. With a language barrier as many other immigrant groups, they acquired jobs in factories and restaurants as waitress and cleaning personnel. And later, most of them became business owners, acquiring the title of entrepreneurs among Latinos, and built what is known today as Quisqueya of the Heights, or Little Dominican Republic. They started also supporting their children to get the best education available in this country, and created programs such as Dominican history courses to keep a center of Dominican culture in New York. Today, they're the fifth largest Latino immigrant group living in the United States, and for over a decade have become the number one seeking for higher education in the city of New York. A 2002 research on Dominicans in higher education by Director of Dominican Institute at City College, Ramona Hernandez, showed that there were more students of Dominican ancestry representing the first generation in their families going to college than any other student group. At the City University of New York, one in two students of Hispanic ancestry was of Dominican origin, making this a characteristic that is defining the new generations of Dominicans born in the United States and on the island that go to college in this country. But why is the value of education taught at home working so well among these new generations? Join me to discover the Dominican Yorker drive into higher education.
Cada día somos más los dominicanos que nos enfocamos en que nuestros hijos vayan a la universidad. Todo el sufrimiento que nosotros como padres pudimos enfrentar viene en ayuda para ellos, porque hacemos un esfuerzo extra para que nuestros hijos no pasen por lo que nosotros pasamos. Y sin olvidarnos quiénes somos, de dónde venimos, se logra dar una educación fuerte a los hijos. Esto no hay nada sin educación.
Superar el nivel académico, superar la pobreza, superar el estilo de vida, no ser igual que tanta gente que no leen, que no van a la universidad, que no hacen nada. Le he dado todo mi apoyo incondicional, todo, lo que sea, para que tenga dos, tres carreras que ella quiera, porque eso es crecimiento, el que yo no tuve, que lo tienen mis hijas.
Muchos de los dominicanos que van a la universidad, el punto de partida es la inspiración de la familia. Poder trabajar duro como inmigrante para poder comprar una casa en su país, poder ayudar a la familia y en algún momento regresar a su tierra.
El dominicano todo lo hace con integridad. La palabra integridad significa hacerlo bien hecho, aún así nadie te esté mirando. Es una sed de establecerte con tus propios pies, por tus propios méritos, por tu propio sudor y de decir, yo tengo un título universitario en esa pared por mi mérito.
Being a Dominican, you know, being a leader, being somebody who is at the top all the time. So, you know, my parents want me to outshine everybody else. Like, it comes from a personal perspective and from a more general perspective. They want you to be a representation of what it is to be an educated Dominican in the United States.
I I think as a sociologist and as a historian, I personally see multiple reasons for that. Number one, we, and I'm saying we because I was born in Dominican Republic and I frequent my nation very often. The Dominican Republic has a very serious lack of serious critical education. Yet at the same time, we are a very proudful and very encouraging people when it comes to pushing forward. We know ourselves as people who will get anything done in whatever means possible. Because of that, education from a very early age, whether you're from the Dominican Republic or you're of Dominican descent, it is part of Dominican culture to push and push our young and our youth to seek the best educational opportunities possible, especially because our parents and our descendants didn't have that opportunity.
They cater to us here a lot also. A lot of CUNY schools, for example, there are Dominican clubs, there's the Dominican Institute in City College, and I feel that that also contributes to allowing Dominicans to feel that they are wanted at these schools, at these universities. People my age as well, they want to become better than the people that they live with, the people that they're surrounded by. So it's that pride again that I'm saying, like, oh, I want to be the best, you know.
That's why, because you want to see yourself there in that position. You want to see yourself working as a doctor. You want to see yourself working as a lawyer. You want to see yourself working as a journalist. You want to see yourself working in an office, not in a restaurant washing dishes. So that's why we make the difference.
Eran las cinco de la mañana. Un seminarista, un obrero. Con mil papeles de solvencia que no le dan pa' ser sinceros. Eran las 7 de la mañana y uno por uno al matadero, pues cada cual tiene su precio, buscando visa para un sueño.